Yep. We got a V-drum kit here. It's nice to shed on. You know, you get on your 15-minute break. You want to come over here, get some chops out. It's always a good go-to. It's also a good thing for us to test on when we need to test out you know, throne shakers, BC2s, butt kickers, things like that. Make sure pads are working well. And then right here we have some more perk. We got wind chimes. And again, more congas. We like to keep things cased up to be nice, but you know, we don't have cases for all of our stuff, so we have to ladder them around.
I've never seen, is that a tumbao?
Super tumba.
Yeah, wow. That's amazing.
Yeah, these are the Giovanni Palladium series.
Wow.
We got the new Fausto Cuevas.
Yeah.
Nice. The fiber skins that Fausto likes here, so try to keep it really nice for our artists. Bongos, like to keep our cradles and other hardware over here, but it's not as exciting this way as it is upstairs. So if you want to come up to the upper mezzanine, we'll come check it out. So
you.
Right this way. And right now, like I said, it's under construction, so things will change at some point. All these cases will eventually be up here, and we'll have this complete. Where you know, we'll have a nicer staircase. Right now, we just gotta have this ladder, so be careful coming up.
Yep.
Getting organized here. Like I said, we got a new Remo and Evans order that came through here. So this is where we keep all of our drum heads. We have to be ready, and you just never know what you're gonna need. So we keep a lot on hand. Clear emperors, coated emperors, plenty of kick drum heads here. Everything from the ambassadors to the go-to P3, coated and clear. And further down this way, some of the not as popular but essential heads that we keep. Right here, we keep our Evans heads. We like to keep a nice stock of these. 360 heads, very nice to have on hand. Don't like to run to a music store every time you get an order. Right this way, you'll see some more. We've got a couple Certos down this way, and we got some overflow hardware that we're trying to get organized right now. Like I said, this is a work in progress. Video dead, silent.
Yep.
You're gonna have, we got a lot of artist logos here. We've had many artists come through here, so you just never know who might be coming through and who needs the logo head. Some of these are out of date because they were for tours that were specific, but we have everything from, let's see, Rihanna here. What's this Rihanna one?
Oh, wow. Chris Johnson?
As It Lays tour.
Oh, wow.
And
who was the drummer? Do you remember?
You know, I'm not exactly sure. I don't know.
Mike Reed, maybe?
Well, Mike Reed, I believe, was... he's on Soul Train right now.
Wow.
I'm not exactly sure who the drummer was with that particular drum head. We have everything in here from Mary J. Blige, Lady Gaga, Kelsey Ballerini, Jake Owen. We got Nate Morton from The Voice.
Yeah.
We got The Voice. And Dierks Bentley, Kelly Clarkson. I mean, you name it. All sorts of award shows. Everything from Oscars to the Grammys. Let's see if I can find something else interesting here. We got Darius Rucker. We do the Grammy, so this came from the Grammy House Band.
Wow, that's so awesome.
So we're there. We do these every year. We did the 60th in New York. We have Center Staging New York out there. And we did the anniversary in New York, but they're bringing them back here to LA. We got Nissan Stewart here. Let me see if I can find a really, really cool one. We got the Late Late Show. We got the Gong Show. This one's a Lady Gaga one.
Wow. Do you guys do a lot of the Super Bowls too?
We've done many Super Bowls. In fact, the one with Gaga, we did that as well. And I believe Chris Johnson is
yep.
the drummer.
Yep. I saw the rehearsals.
Yeah. Yeah, we can get back into this later if you want to come back and check out some of these.
Yeah.
Go back this way because I do have to get back to work here yes. shortly. But here we have some more. Like I said, this is a work in progress, so I'm trying to get these things together. We got marching mm-hmm. drums here. Batao.
Yeah.
Got cajones.
Yeah, wow.
And lots of djembes. We got 23-inch bass drums. Doombex.
Wow.
We got street cans here.
Wow.
Elky street cans. Repaniques.
Wow, this is amazing.
Junior congas.
Is it hard to organize, or is it? How do you develop the system of where you want things to be?
Well, this is actually a rendition of what we had down at the old building. Mm-hmm. As you well know, our drum department used to be with the studios down there, but we're so big now that we just can't do it out of the facility anymore. Mm-hmm. We had to expand, so that's why you see what you see right now. All this has been planned out, and like I said, you're walking into the middle of construction, so it's not quite dialed in yet. I'm sure when you come back next year, you'll see all the partitions, and you'll see all this stuff will be way better organized, mm-hmm. and a lot of overflow that's not fitting nicely here is either going to go upstairs higher up, or we're going to end up putting it out in our C-trains where we have overflow. Mm. So, yeah, that's a, you know, there is a system, and we've pretty much developed it by, you know, on trial basis. It didn't all just come together, but like this is based on the motif that we had down at the old building.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we had a better idea before we laid this all out. We knew exactly what we were doing as far as where we wanted to put things, and you know, we measured everything out to the T. And you know, now we're just trying to reckon with everything, and we've got a lot of new equipment since then, so things are changing.
Come behind you.
Yep.
I'm gonna come behind you.
All right.
So. What would you have to say is the oddest drum-related order call, phone call that you've gotten?
I don't know. We've had some weird ones. I would say that if you've ever seen a one-man band,
mm-hmm.
is probably the strangest order we've ever had. Which we don't have one, but we don't like to say no. So we made one for James Corden on the Late Late Show. And it basically, you know, you got the parts that tie to your hand into your foot, and you know, it's hitting the back of the bass drum behind him like a backpack, and all over the place while he's, you know, and he did it more for a comedy bit, but there's people out there that really do it and do it well. So, mm-hmm. You know, no knock to the one man band. Mm-hmm. It's actually a very, or one woman band,
right?
Whatever. It is amazing. You know, if you can pull it off and you're talented enough to do that. I've seen some people incorporate it with the guitar and the harmonica while doing the drums. And then I've seen some other variations of it as well. But that would be probably the most odd that I can recall off the top of my head.
Wow. Well, Dustin, thank you so
You're
much
so
for your
welcome.
Time. Definitely appreciate it. And I'm sure I will see you again another time.
Will do.
Yes.
See you out there.